So today, a bit of backyard science here in the front yard. It's 33 degrees Celsius, it's a hot day here in Australia. So what I'm testing today is the Elite thermo-insulated sheep's wool. I'm not quite sure it's sheep's wool, but it's a thermal bottle that should keep things nice and cool. I've got that, I've just pulled that out of the fridge. Next to it, I have a standard plastic bottle, the cheaper sort. We'll see how that goes, temperature-wise. I've also got a second test that I'm going to do. These are the Team Fly bottles by Elite, the nice and squeezy ones. I've got a black one and a white one. So every half an hour, I'm going to pull out a temperature gun, which I've got just here. And I'll check the temperature of the water inside the thermo bottle, inside our standard cheapo bottle, and between these two as well. So two separate tests here. Is the thermo bottle going to keep the water cooler than this bottle here? And does the color of the Team Fly bottles actually matter? So I'll set these up here. We'll come back every half an hour and we'll check the temperature. So to start off though, let's have a look at what we're at the moment. Look, I know in touching these bottles, it's going to change the temperature a little bit, but look, best we've got for now. So to test the temperature of these, thermo bottle, 8.4 degrees. The black bottle itself, 11.6 degrees. So just sitting here talking after I pulled them out of the fridge, that one's already a little hotter. So these are those two, which I'll put here and here. Now, black and white, this is going to be very interesting to test. I love these bottles. They're super squeezy. They're easy to drink out of. They're also super thin, so I don't expect them to be very insulated when it comes to the temperature. But black and white, we shall test. So we have 12.1 degrees on the black. 12 degrees flat, very close. So I'll come back in half an hour and check those temperatures again. So again, two tests running at the same time here, the thermal bottle versus the non-thermal bottle and the fly versus the fly, black and white here in the sun. So first half hour check-in here in the hot Aussie sun, our black bottle. 23.4 degrees Celsius. It's still about 32, 33 outside. Our thermal bottle, which should be cooler, 13.1 degrees. So after half an hour, the thermal bottle is a lot cooler. And to our other test, our two Team Fly bottles, Fly Team, Team Fly, squeezy bottles. The white one reads 18.8 degrees and the black bottle 19.8, just as we thought. Okay, we'll put them back and we shall see you in half an hour. Okay, we're an hour in now and things are getting really hot here in the sun. Okay, over to the black bottle, non-insulated. 33.2, that's warming up, that's... Yeah, that's a little bit like soup, so 33.2 degrees there. That's what I'd expect out on the road, those really hot bottles. Okay, insulated bottle. Okay, that's impressive. I didn't think it was going to be that much. 17.3 degrees. That is, yeah, without a doubt, noticeably colder. Absolutely. That's cool. Test is going well. 1 hour in. Let's continue on with those. And over to our Fly Team bottles. Black and white. Everything else the same. White bottle. 25.5. Bit warm. Again, no surprises there. That's actually quite a big difference though. Exactly the same bottles, just different color. Okay, they're back in the sun. We shall see you in half an hour. Hey Siri, what's the current temperature outside?
It's about 31 degrees outside. Hot.
Hot indeed. 90 minutes in. Let's go for our next check of the bottle temps. Black bottle, which was already soup last time. I'm not even going to taste that. That's disgusting. 37.7 degrees. The Elite. Nanogelite. Oh, ladybug. See you later. Okay. Insulated bottle test. 21 degrees. That's pretty cool. That's winning. Okay, over to our test of the other two bottles. I can actually feel the Black Fly Team bottle is warmer, a lot warmer. So the white one is 32.4. And yeah, this is hot. This is going to be about the same as the other non-insulated, I think. 37.7. So I'll do one more test at 2 hours, but look, let's be honest. After about half an hour, that water's gonna be gone anyway in weather like this, but I'm keen to see at the 2 hour mark the difference. That thermal bottle is really impressing me so far. The final temperature test today after 2 hours in the hot Aussie sun. Let's look at the results. This is steaming hot. Black, non-insulated bottle. We all know that familiar taste, and just that is... Yeah, okay. 41.1 with that bottle. Over to our insulated bottle. It feels a bit warm on the outside. After 2 hours in the sun. So what was that? 13 degrees difference at the end though? 14 maybe? And that is still, well, not quite ice cold, but that is beautiful. So conclusion from the Nanogelite dishwasher safe for thermal, BPA speed, etc. All that. These are the way to go. I'm going to be packing two of these for Adelaide next week. Now, it's not just taking them out of the fridge with cold water. When you refill them, the water will stay cold in there. Or if you go to the service station, fill up with Gatorade or whatever you've got. A cold drink goes in, the cold drink stays in. That's very cool. There's a bit of a weight penalty with these. They're a few grams heavier with all the insulation, so you do lose out in capacity a little bit. This is only 500 mil, whereas something like this will be about 650, maybe 700. So not as much real estate inside this as this, but this heated up like nothing else and was disgusting to drink. If you're not racing, this is the way to go. So two of these for Adelaide next week. So over to the Fly Team, while I fall over, bottles, the squishy bottles. For our second test today, degrees, that's terrible, but it won't be as hot as this one. Whoosh! 43.9 degrees for this one here. And that was as expected because this is not insulated, this is super squishy. I do like these for race days and cooler days, but on a hot day, if you would go both of these, hopefully we'll be seeing the teams at the TDU using the white. Well, we'll definitely be seeing, well, it's not Green Edge Orica anymore, it's Mitchelton Scott, but hopefully those guys and girls are on white bottles. There's a few degrees in that. And maybe on non-hilly days where they need to be nice and cool, probably these ones. I'll link below to the full specs of these kind of bottles, but this is the first time I've actually played around with one and I am super impressed with that insulation. Give it 6 months here in Ballarat, we'll be using the insulation to keep the water from not freezing rather than overheating in here. Okay, thanks for watching, that was a bit of fun today. I'll be drinking this one and the rest go on the plants. See you soon.